5 to 7 minutes. What Greg is discussing is anybody's guess.
Now it is yours, not yours.
Every semester, Greg Miller is required to give an impromptu speech. This is a 5 to 7 minute long speech from the specialty speech manual. The Toastmaster will now give a topic, any topic, that is appropriate for a speech of this length, to Greg Miller. Greg, tell us about your greatest love.
For those of you who remembered my speeches in the past, after Alexander and Opportunity Knocks, might remember that I mentioned a girl named Kim. No, not that Moore woman who used to be a member of our Toastmasters Club, but a different Kim, a Kim with yellow hair, and that was the same yellow hair that she used to put in her face, in front of her face, and make Cousin It noises for my amusement. And she is the same yellow-haired Kim who used to be amused by the fact that my watch was set to military time, as she would press the button and alternate it between military time and regular time, which she referred to as being either normal or dorky. I didn't ever expect anything to happen with that girl, Kim. As far as I was concerned, all she was that really, really, really pretty blonde girl in my world history class, fall semester 1999, when I was still in California. She came into my office once, nervous about a test she didn't study for, but she toughed it out. She showed integrity, which I respected. Then, it was Pioneer Night it was Cattle Call at Brawley, California. It was a podunk town that I was passing through, or improving my resume, teaching there, taught this world history class. I went thinking that it would be a good place to be, maybe I'd meet a girl. There she was, that very pretty student, talking to some of her friends who I didn't know, so I just casually said hi to her, and she was very happy to see me. Alcohol may have played a role. Eventually, Opportunity Knocked. I described that process in a previous speech. And then after a couple of weeks of being with her, we have our Saturday night date night. We concluded we really like each other. Then that word like became a different four-letter word, love. Unfortunately, that was the end of the semester. I had a one-year contract. I had to move back to my parents' house in San Diego and plan my next move. I might be back during the fall teaching full-time permanent, or maybe not. And we continued our relationship long distance. She came to my parents' house a couple times. They got along really well with her. I got along really well with her. We had quite a bit of fun. I remember walking through Torrey Pines, and that's where I said that L word for the first time, and she responded. We discussed the possibility of, if I got a full-time job, then I'd spend my first paycheck buying her a diamond ring. I remember that also going to her apartment a couple of times in LA as she transferred to Cal State Northridge, which was my alma mater. That's where I got my master's degree. My brother and his wife and infant daughter moved nearby, so I drove up while my parents helped them move, and she came by, and we spent the weekend together. She met my brother, my sister-in-law at the time, and my niece. Everything looked like it was really good. I met her parents once. We had a lot of fun, and I always wondered what would happen if, unfortunately, it remained, and if, because I did not get that job, and I wasn't in a position to support her, and unfortunately, without going into details, time changed things, she moved on. I moved here. I suppose that's just one of those great what might have been in life. What would have been like to have been with that girl who had a dachshund, and of course that dachshund wouldn't have lasted forever, but we've had other doggies. She was a dog person, I'm a dog person, I don't have a dog now. She liked my bearded dragon, Bailey, at the time when we were dating. I suppose that, you know, we would have had other, you know, I got another bearded, well, a couple bearded dragons since then. She would have liked those, and, you know, we discussed things, other things, like what our kids would have been like. I know this sounds bad in hindsight, but one movie that we watched together was American Beauty, and if any of you saw that movie, you might remember that one of the subplots was he seemed like an okay guy at the time, but Kevin Spacey had a big crush on his teenage daughter's best female friend. Sorry, Kevin, wrong gender. And you know, we discussed things like that and what might have been, what our house would have been like, what we would have named our kids, what it would have been like to have a son, what it might have been like as a daughter. We had a lot of fun together. I learned quite a bit. And although I don't have a watch right now because I have a cell phone, which is off as per club policy, if I, my parents and brother have pressured me to get an Apple smartwatch, so therefore, we could all have everything in sync. We'll know how many calories we burn every day. We know how much we sleep. We know when we sleep, when we're waking. So we'll know when we're bad or good, so we'll be good for goodness sake. We talk about a lack of privacy, my parents will know. But if and when I do get a smartwatch, it'll be set to military time, which Kim referred to as being dorky.